I'm so pissed off.
Hold on, I've got to record because I want to capture your magic. If Robbie's pissed off, I want it recorded. You know what I'm saying? This is the shit people pay big money for. Including me. I'm an Alec Baldwin. Why are you pissed, Rob?
Because, okay, I ordered Rolling Stone. Okay, it doesn't matter. I ordered something on vinyl. I ordered a vinyl. I had a package coming. Okay, that's all okay. I really need to know. I had a package coming. I just got a note. Your package has been delivered. I look, no package. I look in the front, no package. Then I look online. I go to UPS, like where sometimes they have a picture. No picture. It says it was handed to somebody. So then I check my Ring and there's some guy around that time, like hanging out in front of my house. So I get super paranoid. But that didn't lead to anything. So I come back online and look UPS. It was not delivered to my address. So I look where it was addressed, where it was delivered. It was delivered to the post office. It was UPS. So I check my order at Target again. I ordered from Target. Sure enough, it's my shipping address, my house. They delivered. So I called UPS. I went through this whole thing. I finally got them on the phone. They're like, oh yeah, it was transferred to the US Postal Service. Meanwhile, I got an email from Target saying your package has been delivered. How does it look? You know? And I was like, that's not what Target's saying. Like, oh yeah, no. I said, well, they're going to deliver it to me now. And she was like, oh, that you have to call the US Postal Service. You all know what it's like to contact the US Postal Service. So she says, now US Postal Service has it. Target thinks I have it. There's a random dude outside. So I said, okay. She was like, there's a new tracking number. I said, fine, give me the tracking number. Let me read you guys the tracking number. 927-098-3725-8109-1004. This is the longest. I was like, can you repeat that?
But wait, isn't that kind of standard operating procedure for a tracking number? I mean, a tracking number is usually not seven.
They're not that long. That's excessive. That's about six digits too long. But anyway. Okay.
I'll listen to you. I can be with you. I am with you regardless. All through this story. This story, frustrating. Where I kind of exit the freeway is you getting mad about the digit count on the tracking number.
I wasn't expecting it to be a normal tracking number. I thought it was going to be like four numbers.
No,
well, but she was like, you know, I was like, slow down, Toots. I can't keep up.
Well, so what you're really saying is the customer service representative was speaking too quickly for you, Pappy.
That's fine, but that's not my issue. My issue is, where's my package?
I'm not going to play Where's My Package with Rob. There's a reason why we hired Tina.
Yeah. No, guys, we won't be playing Where's My Package on the pod today.
Instead of Cock Block, everybody, we're playing Where's Rob's Package.
Ralph Henry Chilton III is a writer, producer, director, best known for Nip Tuck, Covert Affairs, and the show Ringer with Sarah Michelle Gellar. Ladies and gentlemen.
Mr. Poop himself.
Hank Chilton, everybody.
Hank Chilton!
Rob, did I get a song?
Well, you got the theme, so you'll get it'll say, hey, my guest is... It was like, hey, it'll say... Hey, what you gonna do, Robin? Richard, I'm coming for you. Which is not at all how it goes.
No, that's worse. I drove by your house not long ago. The poop sign's gone. Why'd you take it down?
Somebody stole our poop sign? We didn't take it down.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm dead serious.
God damn it. It's pretty solid poop sign, so I get it.
Poop gate.
You knew it was coming.
It was a clear finger to the neighborhood.
Yeah, Rob, you've always wanted to finger the neighborhood.
Trump's go away, his like closing speech or whatever yesterday was hilarious. It was like, well, I hope they don't raise your taxes, but if they do, I told you so.
I'll be back.
Wasn't his final words like, have a good life, be back? Then YMCA played him out.
One of the things that got Trump elected in the first place was the ridiculousness of him being Trump. I liken it to in fifth grade when I nearly lost to the class piranha. I was the only one running for president, and the other, and so the jerks in the class were like, let's nominate the piranha. We had this little piranha in it. Right. And the piranha, I only beat the piranha by like 5 votes because people were like, we could beat Benedict with the piranha.
How was your debate with the piranha?
One-sided.
I bet he ate you alive.
Hey, better, you win. That was fun. You almost got beaten by a fish.
Yeah, this story, Rob, of when you went back home for the Hall of Fame.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You showed up.
Yeah, went back to my high school. I was elected into my high school Hall of Fame.
And oh.
Like, yeah. And this was maybe 15 years ago. I was like, you know what? I will go back. I'm going to go back to my high school for this event.
This is a prestigious award.
It's a prestigious
award. Honor. Big honor.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Little did I know that about 10 years after I went to high school there, Carl Edwards, the NASCAR driver, who was like number one in the country at the time, he's not anymore, but he's in top five for a long time, also went to school there. And so I was overshadowed. I was like, you know, right before I went up to give my acceptance speech in my class of inductees, there was a special message from Carl Edwards from like the ESPN Center. Where he's like, where they did this whole special video of him riding a car with Rockbridge High School on the side of the car, and it was all the ESPN people, and he was like, yeah, and all the crowd was like, yeah, Carl Edwards, because they love the, you know, race car driving, and then they quieted down. They're like, and then next up we have actor from Los Angeles, actor Rob Benedict. A smattering of applause. I go up and
the piranha was after you and got it roaring. To give the award, Mayor Piranha.
What about your hometown, Hank? Is there a sign that says home of Ralph Henry?
There is nothing like that. Nope.
No.
Yet.
We got, who's our famous people? We have David Naughton, who played
the Dr. Pepper guy.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
American Werewolf in London.
Yeah.
You went to my high school?
Dude, yeah. David Naughton. American Werewolf in London is a phenomenal movie. And David Naughton, I feel like American Werewolf in London, if you did that movie now, like if that movie came out now and had the level of success it had, which was massive, and you're the lead in that, you're now making movies. Like it didn't really launch him in that way.
He had a few movies. I think he even had a TV show for a while.
He did, called Making It.
Making It, exactly.
And there's a disco song called Making It to the Top.
Oh, wow.
Got a chance, I'm taking it.
No more faking it.
When I was in fourth grade, our one screen theater in town, the Central Movie Theater in West Hartford, Connecticut, it turned into a disco. Oh. And during the day, they allowed kids underage to go to the disco. And I went on the first day when it opened, fourth grade, 12 to 4. I went to the disco where all my friends, we went to the disco, we danced, and I loved it. And the next week, I'm like, let's go to the disco. All my friends were like, no, man, that was weird. I'm not going again. I went by myself. I would go to the disco.
Oh my God, Egg.
As a middle schooler.
Yeah.
A fourth grader. That'd be middle school. Yeah. Fourth grade is a year older than Frank, Tina. Just to give you a little.
Just like, did you have an outfit too? Like a little disco outfit?
My outfit was like, it was, you know, those like mesh jerseys that was green and yellow. That was what I wore.
Thank you. How long do you want this?